There's a developing story in Oklahoma this morning. A state agency there has joined the list of experts connecting an increase in earthquakes with one part of the fracking process.
The blame is being placed on injections of wastewater. Hundreds of earthquakes have rattled Kansas and Oklahoma in the recent years. And here's a look at the activity within just the last 24 hours. Three Oklahoma quakes were in the range of 2.5 to 3 in magnitude. But now Cakeland has felt quakes well above 4 even. Cakes Annette Lawless joins us live to look at where we've seen the worst of it.
Good morning, Jamal and Gloria. We've seen a lot of sort of that worst end of the earthquakes even here in Kansas. Now, I'm at the Sedgwick County Dispatch Center. They get a lot of calls from folks when it comes to these earthquakes, but let's take a look at the maps and see where all this activity is happening. Our most recent earthquake happened on Sunday, and it's down in Harper County, just a little south of Anthony. And over here, we can see that injection wells are a big link to what's causing these earthquakes in these cases. That's what the Geological Survey has told me recently. But looking at the numbers as of this past year, Kansas has experienced more than 100 earthquakes. Our biggest month last year was in November. A majority of our earthquakes, though, in November and then overall tend to be that 2 level. So they're the smaller end of the earthquakes. However, back into this year, we see that we've had a lot of activity even here as well. In March is our biggest year, our biggest month rather, and we've had 19 earthquakes that have occurred of a 2-point magnitude, and then we have 6 of them of a 3-point. But you know what? If you want to find more information about earthquakes, maybe kind of dive into some of that data, you can also go over to our website, kick.com. We have a really cool link on our page, on our weather page. So you go to kick.com/weather, go to the earthquake section, and you can actually look at data from the past 24 hours and then look at stuff from the past 7 days over here in Kansas and then in Oklahoma as well. Now, coming up in our next half hour, I'm going to take a look at your questions. Our Facebook viewers have asked a lot of different things in terms of these earthquakes. I'm going to answer them, and hopefully we'll dive into some good discussion there. Reporting live in Wichita, Annette Lawless, KAKE News.